गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव कवर्ड दिस चैप्टर क्लाइमेट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडी अबाउट द क्लाइमेट वेदर सीजन्स एंड मॉनसून व्हाट आर द इन्फ्लुएंशियल फैक्टर्स ऑफ क्लाइमेट ऑफ अ प्लेस दैट इज लैटिट्यूड ऑल्टीट्यूड प्रेशर एंड विंड सिस्टम ओशन करेंट्स एंड रिलीफ फैक्टर्स okay and we have discussed about the Indian monsoon mechanism how the different features affect the monsoon of India and what are the different seasons in India and how the monsoon is the most awaited the phenomena in India which unify the people it is treated as a unifying bond okay so now I'm going to discuss the question answers of this chapter in this video so let's start here the exercise questions are given look at the first one so children look at the first question this is multiple choice question given here we have to tick the answer first is which one of the following places receives the highest rainfall in the world So option is given here Silchar, Cherrapunji, Masindram and Guwahati. So children we know that the wettest place on the earth which receives highest rainfall is Masindram which is located in Meghalaya. Okay, इससे पहले जो था वो चेरापूंजी था लेकिन अब ये change हो गया है ये replace होकर के Masindram हो गया है Then second question we can see the wind blowing in the northern plains in summers is known as Kalbaisakhi, trade winds, loo or none of the above. So children we know that the loo blows in the northern plains during the summer season and it is very harmful if the person cannot expose outside during the summer season. Then question number 3. Which one of the following causes rainfall during winters in the northern west part of India? इस question में थोड़ा सा problem था that we have studied that there is a western cyclonic disturbance, but here the term cyclonic depression is very important for the winter rainfall. So correct option is cyclonic depression. Alright, जो correct option है वो cyclonic depression होगा instead of western disturbance. So all of you make it correct. The correct answer is A option, that is cyclonic depression. Now look at the fourth question. Children, fourth question is monsoon arrives in India approximately in early May, early June, early July or early August. So we are aware of this thing. The monsoon arrives in India in the early June. So students look at the fifth question now which one of the following characteristics the cold weather season in India have okay options are given here warm days warm nights then second warm days and cold nights cool days and cool nights cold days and warm nights all right so correct answer is B option kuch bachchon ko isme doubt tha lekin agar aap ye topic read karenge humne padhaya tha कि इन ड्यूरिंग द विंटर सीजन जो एवरेज हमारा जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक होता है वो वार्म डेज़ एंड कोल्ड नाइट्स का होता है कोल्ड नाइट्स भी होती हैं और कोल्ड डेज़ भी होते हैं लेकिन जो एवरेज कंडीशन होती है वो वार्म डेज़ एंड कोल्ड नाइट्स होती है ठीक है स्टूडेंट्स नाउ लुक एट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन व्हाट आर द कंट्रोल्स अफेक्टिंग द क्लाइमेट ऑफ इंडिया so we have learned that there are influential factors which actually affect the climate of India are latitude we have learned the latitude is an important factor then altitude then also we have learned about the relief factors and pressure and wind system and wind okay and we have also studied that distance from the sea these are some important influential factors which actually influence the climate of India all right so in this way you have to give answers in very short the influential factors are latitude altitude relief factor and pressure and wind system and distance from the sea. Okay. Students, now look at the second question. Why does India have a monsoon type of climate? So in this chapter, students, we have learned that India is lying in between the tropics. Okay. So the upper part is subtropical and the lower part is lying in the tropics, lying in the tropical region. So those countries which are lying in the tropical region receives the monsoon type of climate first of all. So the region from Tropic of Cancer and up to Tropic of Capricorn are basically the convergence of intertropical zones. Alright, ये हमारा intertropical convergence zone में lie करता है, जिसकी वजह से India और बल्कि जो tropic में जितने भी countries हैं उन सभी regions में monsoon type of climate मिलता है. ठीक है, इसके अलावा मॉनसून आने के और अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर्स भी पढ़े हमने, जिसमें हमने पढ़ा कि जेट स्ट्रीम्स जो है वो रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. ठीक है, सो इन दिस वे यू विल राइट दिस आंसर. क्लियर चिल्ड्रन, नाउ लुक एट द थर्ड क्वेश्चन. विच पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया डज एक्सपीरियंस द हाईएस्ट डिरेक्शनल रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर एंड वाई? सो वी नो दैट अवर नॉर्थ वेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया इज राजस्थान एंड राजस्थान कंप्राइजेज डेजर्ट, दैट इज थार डेजर्ट. एंड वन इम्पॉर्टेंट फेनोमेना इज दैट इन डेजर्ट द सैंड गेट्स हीट अप वेरी क्विकली एंड देन अगेन लूजेज हीट very fast. It becomes cool very easily. So during the daytime temperature gets almost 50 degrees Celsius and nights become little cool. The temperature gets little cool during the night time because the sand quickly cools down and the temperature also drops down just because of the wind which moves here. Students, now look at the fourth question. Which winds account for rainfall along the Malabar coast? So here, which winds are bringing the rainfall in Malabar coast? Children, if we will see the map of India, here we have Goa and Goa ke jo niche ke hamare states hai, Karnataka and Kerala, these regions are known as Malabar coast and these regions receive the rains from the southwest winds. जो southwest monsoon winds होती हैं वो इन regions में enter करती हैं और यहाँ से rainfall receive करते हैं Malabar coast वाला region. Okay? Students, now look at the question number 5. What are jet streams and how do they affect the climate of India? So we have explained in the chapter that the jet streams are high velocity winds which moves in the narrow belt or of vertical height around 12,000 meters height in the troposphere, and this is upper air circulation of the westerly flows. Alright, and in summer time it generally the speed of the wind is 110 kilometer per hour and in winters it is almost 184 kilometer per hour. Okay, and how it affects the climate of India? These jet streams are actually blowing from south of the Himalayas all through the year, throughout the year except in summers. So the western cyclonic disturbance experienced in the north and northwestern parts of the country are brought up in by these westerly flow. Alright, in summer the subtropical westerly jet streams move north of the Himalayas with the apparent movement of the sun. An easterly jet stream called the subtropical easterly jet streams that blow over the peninsular India approximately over 14 degree north during the summer months. So in this way, this is given on page number 28. You can see there 28 page left hand side, the left corner, the answer is given here from there. Now question number 6, define monsoon. And what do you understand by the break in monsoon? Children, we know that monsoon is the total reversal of the wind direction, total reversal of the wind direction throughout the year. Okay, When it moves from sea to land, it gathers moisture and then it precipitates on land, and this happens in summer season, okay? And whereas it moves from land to sea in the winter season. So when it comes from land to sea, it doesn't bring any moisture, right? And break of monsoon, children, is known as the wet and dry spells of the monsoon. In between, the monsoon also takes breaks, so that break is called the break of monsoon. यानी जब बारिश होती है ना, दो तीन दिन तक लगातार continuous बारिश होती है, rain होती है, उसके बाद जब एक दो चार दिन बारिश नहीं होती है, उस समय sunshine होता है, तो उसे हम break in monsoon कह सकते हैं, ठीक है? Now look at the question number 7th. Why is the monsoon considered a unifying bond? So children, this question is very important. Monsoon is considered as unifying bond because a lot of changes can be observed after the arrival of monsoon. And this seasonal alteration of the wind system and the associated weather condition which prevails during that time provide a rhythmic cycle of seasons that binds the entire country and the entire landscape, plants and animals, life of the people, you know, they are waiting for the arrival of the monsoon, arrival of the water after hot weather season, okay? So in this way the rainfall change their life and get into a festive way, right? And the you know, they change the life of the people on the earth, and the farmers, that is the most important you know, phenomena for the farmers, because their entire cropping calendar is depends on the monsoon. They wait for the water, एंड उनका जो पूरा इंटायर जो क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम होता है वो मॉनसून पे डिपेंड करता है. सो दैट इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्टिविटी फॉर देम.